Okay, we should be live. Welcome. A little later than I would have wanted, but I was trying to do something fancy when I really shouldn't be doing that right away, so whatever. How's everyone doing? Close this crap down. Let's just put this on. Now we'll come back to that. How about just put on some MCC in the background while we're waiting? Anyway, obviously, let me know throughout the stream how the audio levels are. I assume it should be started by now, but we aren't missing anything. Yeah. But yeah, today we're going to get to see the first real E3 showcase in almost 2 years, and hopefully another look at, Halo Infinite, one that's much more favorable than last year's. At the very least, we'll get to see multiplayer. So I'm very excited about that. But I don't know. How about anyone else? How y'all feeling? Ian, you got Discord for us to join to chill in? Unfortunately, not. that's one of those things I really do want to do, and it's something I want to do very soon. I just haven't had the opportunity or the means just yet to create my own Discord. Yeah. Good to hear everything's sounding fine. Obviously, things may change once we get to the actual live stream or whatever. But, you know, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Looks like they're actually counting down now, so that's good. Anyway. There, that's what I want. Dead. And we got 88 viewers in here so far, so that's pretty awesome. Good to see everybody. I hope, like I said, I hope everyone's doing again. The Halopedian Discord is open. I mean, I don't know if I want to if everyone's okay with that, yeah, I could jump in there and broadcast that. How's your day been? Any hopes you want to see at the Xbox show and Bethesda showcase? My day's okay. I actually just got back from California this morning at about 7 a.m. It took a red eye flight to get started. The actual Xbox stream starts in about half an hour, or probably closer to 20 minutes now. But yeah, I just got back from California. I don't know if you can see it here. I actually got some sunburn. Me and my family went to Alcatraz Island, and I did not expect to be outside for so much of that. I got burned because I am naturally pale as F. Yeah, Discord would be awesome. It's one thing I definitely need to get done. Maybe in these next couple of months. So many YouTubers are streaming. Yeah. I have to say, I have been very excited for, I am very excited for how Xbox has been handling this. Like, I don't know if y'all read the Xbox Wire post that they made about the whole thing today. They're basically saying, I think the coolest thing was, like, we want to make sure that the music isn't going to interfere with y'all. So we worked with our partners to make sure that it'd be okay. It's not a guarantee, but we're doing our best. Really hope AI is an Infinite Forge. Yeah, that would be really cool. Halo TV show leaks review. Obviously, if anyone follows me on Twitter here, I have seen the leaks. I don't know. Maybe we'll talk about it. I guess it depends on what we see today, because based on, like, it looked like that was a completed trailer that leaked on Twitter. Like, obviously, for anyone who's not in the know, a bunch of images were leaked of the Halo TV show. Allegedly, at least. It looks to be pretty legit. If we don't see that today, then yeah, maybe I could. We'll see what we see today. And, you know, oh, hey, Jeff Easterling, Grim Brother One's in here. Hey man, how you doing? Happy Xbox Day indeed. Or Xbox Bethesda. I saw the X-B and I thought Xbox. No, it's Xbox/Bethesda. That's awesome. Yeah. Hey Aiden. Yeah, I'm doing pretty fine. Mark 4, Mark 5, or Mark 6 for the TV show, or Mark 5 or Mark 6 for the TV show. Unfortunately, well, the images show the Mark 6 Gen 3 right now. But as some people have pointed out, that could be like a flash forward, or that could be like set during Infinite, and then the show is set during, or is set as a flashback or something, which is what I'm hoping for, if nothing else, but I'm not holding my breath. I think they're going to go for full Mark 6 Gen 3 for the show, much to my disappointment. Because I want Mark 4! Mark 4 looks so good! Master Chief would look so good in Mark 4! Anyway. Hope all is well. Are you hoping for more? What are you hoping multiplayer is like? More classic Halo 343, a mix of both? I mean, we've already seen from the campaign demo, their slide is in there, Claymore is in there, Sprint is in there, and you know they're not doing that just for campaign. I guarantee you, Halo's never been like that. I doubt it will ever be like that. You know, they Halo not just wants, but I'd argue needs to have a unified experience. You can't go into campaign, have one experience, and have multiplayer be a very different experience. Not in my opinion. You could have minor differences like Halo 4 had, where, you know, obviously in campaign you don't have actual loadouts, but yeah, there needs to be a pretty unified experience. So I'm hoping for more of a middle ground, though I'm the kind of guy that felt like Halo 5 was kind of a pretty good middle ground. So, you know, we'll see. Honestly, as long as the game is fun, that's what I want. I want a fun game. And if it looks fun, that's what matters. And I'll say the campaign demo last year looked fun. Greetings from Mexico. Hi there, Isaac. Hope you're doing well down there. Got any good steaks? Yes. He looked fire and FUD in Mark IV. I still don't like the Mark VI, Mark IV crap they did for the Forward Unto Dawn series. As I have made evidently clear, I think, throughout the life of this channel, but whatever. How'd you like the Sand Shyum? They looked great, honestly. They definitely looked more hu like they tried to make them more human. So possibly trying to make them more sympathetic or easier to sympathize with. But it looked like a San Shyum. It looked like a prophet, so I'm pretty happy with that. And it even looked like the rubble was in there, so that would be pretty cool if we're visiting. What I ultimately want from the TV show right now, I just want a statement that it's not going to be canon with the show or with the rest of the continuity. It sucks that that's probably going to happen, but I just want that. I want that so I can move on and maybe get some semblance of joy out of the show. I don't know. The San Shyum looked like a Power Rangers villain. I mean, if you say so, but it looked like a San Shyum. There were some minor tweaks, like the nostrils were hot, the face was longer, the nostrils were a little closer together. Like I said, they kind of humanized it more, but it looked like a San Shyum. So it has not. I thought it's not canon. I thought it's been said it. No, it has not been said yet. It very much looks that way. I just want a definitive statement because I can't move on without that. I like the FUD armor, but the Halo Wars Mark IV is amazing. Like, let me make this perfectly clear. And I'm not trying to call anyone out with that tone. I just realized how accusatory that tone sounded. No, I just want to make my point of view perfectly clear here for a sec. You know what, I'm just gonna put up I was gonna play for a bit, but no, we're just gonna put up the background. Nope, that's not what I want. Swear they. There we go. Okay, we'll just full screen that quickly. Quality. Yeah, we're doing 1080 bitches. Okay, so Mark the FUD armor. I like the armor in theory. I like the look of the armor. I do not like it in the context of Forward Unto Dawn because it has shield emitters. Oops. There we go. It has shield emitters. The fusion power packs on the back are way too small for the time. And in fact, they, according if based on what we know now from what's it called? Silent Storm and Oblivion, they should have been fission power packs, but regardless, they're way too small for the time period. And I love the Halo Wars Mark IV. I want to see that. If nothing else, I'll say in later years, the Project Cobalt stuff that they used in Silent Storm, Oblivion, and Collateral Damage looks much better. Yeah, it looks like Mark 6, but it much more heavily resembles Mark 4 than simply putting Mark 6 on someone and trying to tell us, you know, it's like pissing and telling us it's raining. I take shit very seriously. Super ethereal. What do we got? Another thing, didn't it take place in 2526? I mean, Chief is 15 years old. Yes, it did. They actually highlight that in the show when Fred and Kelly take off their helmets. But Chief keeps his on because we've got to have the mystery, guys. I hate. That is my biggest annoyance. Whenever other Spartan 2s specifically, like if Spartan 3s do it and Spartan 4s do it around him, that's one thing. If other Spartan 2s take off their helmets around Chief, but Chief keeps his on, I hate that. It takes me immediately out of whatever I might be watching or enjoying because there's no reason they would in most situations, but the Chief wouldn't. I suppose you could argue it works in Forward Unto Dawn now that I think about it, because the Chief was actually like at the back of the Pelican aiming out. So, you know, he was kind of like keeping overwatch, make sure nothing was following them. So it makes sense for him to keep his on while Fred and Kelly could take theirs off reasonably. So there you go. A little bit of realization right here live on stream. Hope you all enjoy that. Oops. Cool. A little bit of music. Let's enjoy that for a bit. I gotta close my exit. Okay. I'll turn that down just a little bit more. So I don't know how loud it is for y'all, but it is. Okay. There we go. Bring that up just a bit. So you can hear a little bit of the background music. I can get one of the presence of other military personnel, but not much. Yeah. What do you think we'll see at E3? I mean, I'm just expecting multiplayer. I think we might see a TV. I wouldn't be surprised if the TV show dropped a trailer, but I also wouldn't be surprised if it didn't. I am hoping we get to see even just like a. I'd like to see a campaign trailer that's basically like somebody said this on Twitter, and I absolutely agree with it. And if that person's in here right now, I'm sorry for not crediting you. I can't remember who said it, but somebody said they wanted to see the exact same footage from last year, just with you know, the new upgrades that 343 has obviously been putting into the graphics. So I would actually like to see that. Yeah, here's hoping the stream doesn't lag. Funny thing. So yeah. Screaming Midget is saying, here's hoping the stream doesn't lag like last year's E3. Funny thing, that was exclusive, or more or less exclusive, to YouTube, it seemed. Because I watched people that were watching it through Twitch, which is what I'm doing this year, because of last year's kerfuffle. And Twitch seemed to be fine, so it was some weird thing with YouTube, or the dual stream there. Someone was asking about dual wielding. There it is. Dual wielding, bummer or nah? I mean, I've never been hardcore on dual wielding. I think you could make it work, but in a variety of ways. Like Ascend Hyperion has a great video talking about that. But if it's gone, I'm not shedding a tear. Let's say. What about the Mark IV B being reused from Noble Team armor for FUD? I thought that was an okay way to, you know, make the most out of your assets. I wish they didn't have to do that, but you know. What can he do? I did like how Grim Brother 1 went into Fred's profile on Waypoint not long after that and basically made a note that Fred liked to use the Mark IV B, like to basically canonize that armor set. I remember back when he was just a community member, he that was like his head canon. And then once he got to work for 343, he made it official canon. Like that's the dream, man. Get to take your head canon to explain little visual inconsistencies. I wish they didn't have to exist, but whatever. And, you know, make it so, as Picard would say. Chances of more spinoffs later down the line after Infinite. I really want, I want more and more spinoffs, man. I am looking forward, I am not eager for, but I'm looking forward, so to speak, that might not be the best way to put it, to the Chief's story coming to a close, and then moving on to, or progressing to, not necessarily a single new protagonist, but to other stories. What's your favorite, Doom Guy or Master Chief? Master Chief. I'm more into the lore of Halo, so that's basically it. Though I do need to get into the lore of Doom a bit more. I'm vaguely familiar, passively familiar with it, but not as much as I would like to be. Wreck weapons returning as weapon upgrades, that would be awesome. I want to see, like, despite the issues with Warzone, I think the wreck weapons were one of the coolest things. Not necessarily because with their connection with the
the microtransactions, but the fact that you had all these different types of weapons that did all these different things, that was one of the coolest aspects of Halo 5, especially once you get into Super Fiesta. That is so cool. So I want to be able to enjoy that again in Halo Infinite. And it seems like they'll be adding more weapons as the game goes on, so even if we don't have a huge variety at launch, as the game expands, that should hopefully be viable, I guess. How would you feel if Master Chief became a playable fighter in Super Smash Bros.? I'd probably play more Smash Bros. I still play a little bit, but that would be awesome. Hope another Banished campaign comes up. Yeah, I would love to have a dedicated Banished campaign. Doom lore is basic. The stuff I've read, it's very interesting. It may not be that as deep, but it's as Halo has gotten to be over the years, but it's pretty interesting, I think. How would you feel if 343 brings back Gray Team but have them in Gen 3? I'd be fine with that. Anything to get me more Gray Team is a win. Be that in books or in games, that'd be awesome. So if you bring them to games, don't just have a basic Halo shooter. Do something unique with them. Will we ever get a lore explanation on why Spartan knives are indestructible noble phantasms? I mean, they're made of hardened titanium, so they're not indestructible, but when you have a very hard knife being stabbed or motioned with by a super soldier, they're going to stab a lot of stuff. So if armor is unlocked with Rex again, how do you think that will work with the expanded customization in comparison to Halo 5? I don't think is going to be unlocked by Rex. They've already said that they're not doing loot boxes. I mean, granted, they said no real world money loot boxes, but I think that you can extrapolate that to mean no loot boxes, period. At least I hope so. So I think we're going to get a more traditional armor unlock experience, though one that is also supported by microtransactions too. Well, actually, I don't think armor itself, I'm hoping armor itself won't be unlocked like that. I'm hoping that'll be more of a traditional thing. But maybe some will. I don't know. It's really hard to say. Anything goes. I'm hoping, though, that it's just traditional unlocks. Predator versus Elite, which would kill the other first? The bias in me wants to say Elites. But I don't know enough about Predators to really make a good judgment call. Like, I've seen Alien versus Predator, and I've seen Predator, and that's about it. Based on those, I think the Elite would have a good chance, but it's hard to say. What else we got here? I think you could do a Ghost Recon style game with Gray Team. Yes, exactly. Personally, I've always wanted like a Spartan 3 game like that. So you're in spy armor and you really have to use the stealth. But yeah, if Gray Team came along, I'd love stealth mechanics. What game mode do you think will be shown in the presentation? I'm guessing Big Team Battle, because there have been so many leaks and rumors about like an expanded BTB mode. And I really want to see that. I really wants to. Okay, hold on. I got to retweet something quickly. Yep, I meant to quote tweet. Come on down and join us for the stream. Just retweeting the stream location here. So, you know, try and get some people in. Okay, back to the feed. Okay. Anyone else's screen's very pixelated? You know what? I just realized my stream preview is playing on YouTube, so that's probably eating up a bunch of stuff. Yeah, though, let me know if things get wonky. Speaking of which, wasn't the domain destroyed? So the domain itself wasn't destroyed. The connection to the domain was destroyed. It's hinted that the domain actually isn't a precursor creation, but something that they just managed to connect to. And that was done through an AI called Abaddon, or Abaddon, depending on your pronunciation. I like Abaddon, personally. About a century after the firing of the Halo rays, some of the remaining Forerunners managed to reestablish that connection. So that's why it exists, but it doesn't have all the information and wasn't like the Didact couldn't connect to it because that old connection was gone. Toe, I just want to say I love you and your work. You made me love Halo again. Well, thank you, Hunter. I'm very happy to hear that. I'm glad even through my bitching that you were able to love Halo. What do you think happened to the Prometheans after Cortana's return? Did all of them submit to her, or there were some sort of schism among them? As far as we can tell, they're just purely under her control. There doesn't seem to be... If 343 wanted to do like some kind of thing where Prometheans are like slowly regaining free will and pulling away from Cortana, that'd be cool. I wouldn't say no to that. What do you think about the voice actor for Locke leaving for Marvel? Unfortunate, but I really like the guy who replaced him, so I'm not too broken up about it. For Halo first up in the stream, midway through, or is the final? I'm thinking it'll start the stream and end the stream. Like, we'll have the BTB reveal at the start and then a trailer at the end. Halo, Elden Halo Ring. I'll be honest, I don't know what the hype with Elden Ring is, but I haven't, you know, maybe I'll find out today. We'll see. I think we'll get new characters' armors in Infinite, like Cat and Emil. I think we'll have Gears of War characters' armor in Infinite. Yes. I don't know. I would love if they made like a Gears of War cog armor or something for Infinite. That would be cool. I'm hoping there is going to be some kind of return the favor, so to speak, since Cat and Emil went to Gears. Attachment options are not just limited to helmets now. Guy in the front has Mark 7 torso with a collar attachment. Yeah. I mean, we'll have to wait and see. They said Reach style customization. I hope that also includes some Halo 4 style stuff, because I think Halo 4 had even better customization, but that's me. But yeah, attachments, we'll see how expansive they get. Do you think we're going to see campaign DLC? Yes. I am like 100% sure that's happening. Do you also want 343 to explore the precursors more? Maybe to a limited degree. Like, the precursors are like that top level Lovecraftian beings that I don't want to get those fleshed out too much. I think fleshing out the Forerunners was fine, especially because we got the precursor mystery on top of that to kind of take its place. What do you think Bethesda will present? I don't anything on Starfield. I honestly have I barely follow Bethesda games most of the time, so I have no idea. It's going to be a surprise for me. I don't even know what Starfield is. Sorry. Thoughts on Amnesia Outlast style game where you play a civilian escaping the Covenant? I'm not too familiar with Amnesia and Outlast, but I think I get what you're talking about there. Basically, yes. I want, in truth, I want Halo to try just everything. Throw everything at the wall, see what sticks. That's what I want from Halo as it grows. What's your favorite armor in Reach that you want to see in Halo Infinite? I mean, the Mark 7 is already basically the Mark 5B, so that's up there. Otherwise, I want my classic Mark 5, though probably something closer to that 20th anniversary image that we saw than the Halo Reach version. Either one's good, though. Let's see, singular armor, probably Gungnir. Gungnir was one that I really loved rocking, both in Halo 4 and Halo Reach, almost at 5. But yeah, I'd love to see that one. Todd Howard announces Skyrim for next gen again. Todd Howard announces Skyrim for Halo Infinite. How about that? There's your announcement. Are you streaming through Twitch or YouTube? I'm streaming through YouTube right now, but the video is through Twitch. Have you finished AOT manga? Attack on Titan manga. Okay. No, I have not. I have not finished that. Do you think we'll have DLC where we play as Jerome 092? Maybe. Halo Wars 3 is not happening, and I'm pretty sure they're going to eventually cross that over fully into the Infinite main timeline, so maybe it's very possible, I think. And because people have been asking for it, and it seemed like it was set up, you'll probably have Isabel along for the ride in your head. I'll just be interested to see what, if that happens, what role Douglas and Alice take. Any Forge predictions? Not expressly, but I'm hoping that that whatever Forge is, it has to be at least on the level of Halo 5 right now. In terms of what you can do, the amount of assets available to you, all that jazz. I would love if AI were a thing, though. Do you think John will take off his helmet during or at the end of Infinite? Maybe. If that happens, I think it'll be a back shot. Like, we'll just see the back of his head, or we'll see, it'll be like Halo CE-esque where he takes off the helmet, but you can't see his head at all. But I would love if we got like even a more of a partial face reveal, though. But I think at the very least, by the end of this 10 year saga for Infinite, we will have the Chief have a full on face reveal. I hope so. At least I'm going to push for that over the next 10 years, if nothing else. Do you think we're going to see bosses in Halo Infinite? Yes, I absolutely do. It's pretty much guaranteed with some of the stuff. Thoughts on the show leaks? We talked about this earlier. Sorry. Yeah, we can always circle back and talk about those in more detail if nothing happens. We're 20 seconds away, which might be further for you guys because I know there's a slight latency here. Monkey Titan versus Atriox with a big, really big stick. What Halo games do you dislike? There's no Halo game that I dislike. I like each Halo game usually for what it is and for its own reasons. Okay, here we go. Let's start. Oh no, mature. I can't watch this. Seto Z? I'm going to have to look up the... Oh, that's cool. I'll have to look up the Jap... I'm guessing that's the Japanese system. Okay. Obviously, let me know how the volume is. Especially in comparison to my own voice. Because I want you guys to hear me, but I want you to be able to hear what's going on here. Alright. Saying too low, but the volume should come up in a little bit. Let me know in just a minute if it's still too low. More volume. Okay, I think that's enough. I'm just going to turn this all the way up on here, and I'll just give a slight adjustment here. Okay, how about now? A little more. Okay.
20 years. That's how long Xbox has been with us. And like you, this is a moment I always look forward to. I love seeing the new games, crossing my fingers
good.
For
That's
my
awesome.
Favorites to return. Hoping
and you guys
for a
can hear me
surprises.
Just fine, right? Because I assume
all,
you're
though,
here for me, too.
I love
too.
Seeing everyone around the world come together and celebrate what games mean to all of us. And
all
I think,
right,
you know,
right,
this past
right.
year, they've meant even more. Thank you for being with us today. Thank you for the support you give us and one another. Xbox is turning 20. And
which means
I
we're gonna
wouldn't
need
be
four
here
times
if
the
it
detail.
Wasn't for the friendships we've had that whole time. At Bethesda, we believe video games do one thing better than anything else.
All right,
they transport
saying good,
us
so that's good.
Through art and technology.
Skyrim 2 times.
There's real magic when you step into a new world and can make it your own. We've traveled the worlds of Elder Scrolls, of Fallout, and now, for the first time in over 25 years, we're creating a new universe with Starfield. Set
okay.
hundreds of years in our
well,
future,
look at that. Starting
it's an
with Bethesda.
Epic
cool.
about hope. Our shared humanity and answering our greatest mystery. It's a game we've dreamt of playing. And it wasn't until now that we have the hardware, the technology, and the team who's hard at work at home to make that dream a reality. We're excited to finally share our first in-game teaser and something to look forward to.
All right. I like sci-fi, so let's see. And nothing else.
Helium 3 tanks checked. Seals are intact. We are still go.
Okay, I was gonna say that better not be the only the extent of the teaser. That looks like a giant Halo health pack.
They say, the wonder
get some
is,
very alien vibes.
Not that the field of stars is so vast,
oh,
but that we
cool.
have measured it. You're part of Constellation
do
now.
Not use.
Part of our family. What you've found, it's the key to unlocking everything. This is all we've been working towards.
Looks good.
We've come to the beginning of humanity's final journey.
Prepare for departure.
Some droids walking around out
Graviton
there.
Graviton loop array full check. Your space lane is clear.
That's why we're here.
Main engines go.
That sounds Jen. Maybe.
To discover what's out there.
No, that's not Jen.
You are go for launch.
So November 11th, 2022. I gotta say, that's a pretty ingenious way to end to announce the release date. That's pretty good. Starman Sky. Yeah, I'll admit I'm interested. Xbox exclusive. Nice. Which also means it's coming to PC.
It is awesome to share with you for the very first time one of the most anticipated games in the world from Todd Howard and the team at Bethesda Game Studios. A
Starfield feels like No Man's Sky and Fallout.
Yes,
yeah, that's probably
exclusive.
On purpose.
Welcome to the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase. I am so excited and proud
PS4
to be here
on,
today
oh God.
Celebrating games. Because although it's been an incredible
Did you get the new console? Funny enough, I've gotten a PS5. I have not been able to get an Xbox Series X.
Joy and connection. We are committed to forging the next era of gaming, conjuring worlds never before possible, unlocking play across
all
devices,
so I'm thinking now,
and delivering the power of games
to Bethesda, then
everyone.
Xbox, maybe?
And now, we get to share that quest with Bethesda. Not just as partners, but as one team, united in bringing the very best games to more people everywhere. So today, we get to reveal more of what's
to come. Joe better present the Halo panel.
We have an amazing
That'd be pretty cool.
show. 30
we'll
titles,
be a deal breaker,
27
awesome.
In Xbox Game Pass. And of course, every single console title you'll see today is optimized for Xbox Series X and S, offering next-gen performance, speed, and features. We get to work with the best studios on Earth. Next is something truly riveting. The latest entry in the haunting and evocative franchise created by GSC Game World, Stalker 2. Coming first to Xbox Series
so
consoles
I'm thinking maybe
and
Halo
PC.
Will be towards the end.
This will be a true next-gen experience,
haunted
targeting 4K resolution and ray tracing. Let's take a look at what you'll get to play when it launches next year.
Vault Boy armor coating for Halo Infinite. I'd be up for it. That'd be awesome. Hold up. This ain't Halo. Yeah.
Like I'm spotted.
Ну, чего там?
Готово.
Ну и пошли они нахрен.
All right, I like this already.
Спасибо тебе.
I like that it's
Ты
all
многим
this
сталкерам жизнь спас.
I assume that's Russian.
Ну, давай, малюй картину маслом.
Wait, so it's just the announcers that are there? Yes, there's no live audience because of COVID still. So, I do not envy them. I've seen like live, but it's like doing a presentation. Without anybody in the audience. It is difficult, so credit to them.
Вот поэтому я ни в какие разборки и не лезу. Не хочу пулю поймать.
Ну не знаю. Между аномалией и маслиной я уже лучше
пулю. The sound ever sees this, the guy that was just talking looks a lot like you. Oh my. You had my curiosity. Now you have my attention. I know that's not how it goes, but that's how I'm doing it.
Вот ты говоришь, а я прям вижу красоту эту. Не первый год в Sony, вроде примелькалась уже.
а каждый день удивляет.
Capitalist.
Зона надоесть не может.
Говорят, ты знаешь, где вход в фундамент.
Тише, тише.
You haven't missed anything. It's like Halo related.
Узнаешь мотив?
I swear, it looked like the floorboards were actually moving under his feet.
Слыша.
Probably
вот
not.
Это
Probably
культура.
Just the stream.
А ты That's одно и то же по кругу лобаешь.
Сам же просишь. У меня муз училище, если что.
О, мессия. Прошу прощения. Может, вам к ученым? Профессура. Они вам лабораторию найдут.
They announced Halo Reach 2. Yeah, that was pretty epic. Hope we don't get copyrighted. Yeah, Xbox said they were gonna, like, they were working to avoid that, so hopefully I won't. We'll have to see, though. Oh, shit.
Да пошел ты.
I love this trailer. This is great.
Зря ты так с друзьями. Ты же его на вылазки таскаешь.
Чего-чего? А дружбы? В зоне я точно не встречал.
Это верно.
Он мучился?
Нет.
Это хорошо. Он этого не заслужил.
А пулю заслужил. Жаль, что ты так с ним поступил.
Мне тоже. Считаешь, я не думал, как обойтись без его смерти?
Она не могла быть свободна, пока он жил.
Зато теперь
посмотри на нее!
Нет, Скиф, я не отдам ее никому. Зона дала мне жизнь, новую жизнь. Жизнь, которую я готов вернуть, если потребуется. Я буду защищать ее. Всегда.
I don't know what the hell's going on, but I am interested. This is a sequel, so I gotta go out and play the original, I suppose.
Похоже, пора.
И куда ты теперь?
В Припять. Нужно с ним поговорить.
Удачной охоты, сталкер.
Interesting. Is that Chris Redfield? April 2022? Okay. Yeah, it does look pretty sick, I won't lie. I might check out the original so I can get up to date on what it's about. Oh, nice.
We're surviving here.
Halo Garfield edition up next.
Five is not enough. We've got to fight. No, we don't need to do anything. All right, when was the last time you saw written in any numbers?
All of my best friends, like to run, get up. Oh my. Oh my.
No rest for the wicked.
Let's go!
You're here! Come on!
So, Left 4 Dead 3?
God, I love Mondays.
I know it's not actually. Blood for Dead? Left 4 Halo. Oh shit, that's cool. If, I don't know if this is co-op, I might get it to play with some friends. It looks like it is co-op. Yeah! There it is, queen! I'm guessing Halo's gonna be towards the end.
Buckle up, buttercups.
We've got one shot. Let's make it count.
Over here!
Oh, You might need a back four blood. Oh yeah, so it's basically Left 4 Dead. Starving for Halo for the main event, yeah. We're saving Halo for the main event as usual. Watch, this is Halo. Yeah. I'm digging this soundtrack though. Avalanche Studios, okay. Oh, from Just Cause, alright. Just Cause 4? You change two things about Halo, what would that be? That is too broad. There's so much. Elevator music the game. There you go. I gotta say, I like this trailer. It's showing some cool shit. It's a cool, they're doing cool ways of telling you what the thing's gonna be about. This would be the one I'd be worried about getting flagged for. Oh, Contraband. Okay. I think I hit my mic there. Sorry if that... GTA 6. Yeah. We already have that. It's Gears of Halo Theft Auto. Okay, Sea of Thieves. I never got into this, but I understand it's very popular with certain people, so you know what? I'm glad that it's getting that it keeps getting love for the people that do enjoy it. Getting some Guardians of the Galaxy vibes from the previous one, yeah. I can't wait for Guardians 3.
Blues from beyond the horizon. A new
okay, I was gonna joke about having like Pirates of the Caribbean vibes from this, but that lady literally looked like Calyptus or whatever her name was that showed up at the end of the second movie and was part of the third one. Life.
You must start.
It turned out to be the god or whatever.
Life of one.
Gears of Eternal Halo Fallout.
Oh! Didn't realize we had.
Oh God! It is a. It is. I called it. It's a. It's
Jack Sparrow.
It's. Well,
but
you know what? It's about
you
time.
You already knew that.
It's about time. Calypso, that was her name. Thank you.
Because of the treasure Jack stole, a darkness followed him here. And if it's not stopped, this world will sink
into
shadow.
Oh, hey, it's Mr. Gibbs, I think his name was.
This sea holds many secrets.
Ah, a new body at last.
All I can
I wonder if we're
going
to get to see Barbossa.
From what I hear of this so-called Sea of Thieves, it's nothing but cursed crews, bloodthirsty mermaids, a legion of dead, angry pirates. Oh, yes. And now, one Davy Jones.
Of course they're doing Davy Jones.
Hello! Well, I believe that now is the perfect time to use these cannons.
The crab fires the cannon.
Without the eternal abyss. It's a world that refuses to face the truth. Nothing lasts forever. Destroy that!
Well, Xbox is certainly embracing the ridiculous nature of this game series, and I love them for it.
I don't suppose, by chance, there's a second one of those? The Sea of Thieves, eh? Bring me that horizon.
I wonder if that's actually Johnny Depp or if that's an impersonator, because it's times where it does not sound like him at all, but maybe Johnny Depp is just not giving a shit. Yeah. Kind of sad not to see Barbossa, but, you know, whatever. I don't play the game, so.
Oh, yeah, extreme!
Thank you. There were six Yakuza games? Jesus.
Hey, how's it going?
Let's do this!
Reputation is everything. If a Yakuza shows weakness, he's done.
Time to call!
It's not Johnny Depp, it's the guy who plays in Kingdom Hearts. Okay, yeah, so... Guy's doing an impression.
Order!
I'd be surprised if they actually got Johnny Depp. Join Operation UNSC Elite with Red and Blue Team, joined by Arbiter and Shipmaster. That would be the ultimate fan service, and I'd be okay with that kind of fan service. Introducing Yakuza 20. Yeah, maybe. Why do they keep... What is with the lobster? There's got to be some joke there that I just don't know. Okay.
Incoming fire!
So what is this? The new Call of Duty or the new Battlefield? Battlefield, okay. I actually have not watched the 2042 trailer, so this is my first experience with it.
We pushed them back, but not far enough.
Oh, Tom Hanks' brothers plays Woody in Kingdom Hearts? That's weird. Halo has not been revealed yet, no. Hey, that's Halo's thing. How dare you have a grappling hook? Only Halo could have anything. That is a cool visual, I will not lie. Is that like a game type where you're just like... Is this their battle royale mode and like their wall is the desert sand? If so, that's a pretty good way to do it. I don't know, maybe this will actually get me into a battle royale mode. Because I like Battlefield. I like it well enough. Yeah, I'm guessing this is Battle Royale. Okay. Watching this while while eating your Sunday roast. Nice. I have not eaten anything in about 12 hours. I am starving. $70 for a game with no campaign? Jesus Christ. Battlefield Canada is not happening, I promise you. Sorry. I might talk about Starfield, it seems interesting. People casually parachuting around a rocket being launched. I know you guys are, some of y'all are saying it's not Battle Royale, but that looks like Battle Royale. I don't know, but I haven't followed anything, so maybe there's a definitive statement. Console launch exclusive.
So, how was your day?
Oh, you know.
I have something to share.
Oh, I remember this.
Police, you're under arrest for your father's murder 8 years ago.
What's going on?
Shut up! You know what this is.
You've been lying to me all this time?
I should never have told you.
I'm out of patience.
What?
I know I say this a lot, but I love you.
I say this a lot too, but back at you.
I'm interested. No idea what it's about, but I'm interested. Am I on time or do you miss? No, Halo has not shown yet.
Approaching the motherlode.
I would love Halo Wars 3, but I don't think that's happening.
Psychonauts headquarters.
Oh, nice!
Gadgets.
The mind is the final frontier of humanity.
I'm ready for anything.
All right.
Oh.
justice!
The fate of the free-thinking world is in your hands.
I'm afraid that means the dead letter office for you.
The mission is falling apart.
A psychonaut must always remember.
And I forgot who voiced this character. I love it. All right, I had forgotten. It's a fantastic voice actor.
What am I doing?
This is a mission about the fate of the world. Can you do that?
Yes, if I can find some bacon.
I'm going to ignore that last part.
Bacon is important, people. Well, the Halo's the only thing people want to see on this channel because it's a Halo channel. But yeah, Halo is still a big seller despite what anyone says.
This is usually the moment when I say hello and welcome to the Bethesda E3 showcase. We love that we can share the stage with Xbox this year, and whether you've known Bethesda for 35 years or are just getting to know us, we couldn't be happier to bring you the latest on your favorite games.
Oh, never realized Zim is also Moxie from Hell of a Boss.
Who gave you a first look.
Good to see some Hell of a Boss people, fans
in here.
Love that. Love that show. I cannot wait
to work on the projects that have been in development since well before we joined the Xbox family.
Whatever, like the full series to come out.
So rest assured, the games you've been expecting and hoping for are still in the works. And today,
I don't think they will show Halo. They are showing Halo today. It was literally part of the primary image.
That includes several
games, starting with Bethesda, and then
once we get
to Xbox, we'll see.
If you're looking for another reason to play it, Halo. Doom Eternal will be optimized for Xbox Series X and S on June 29th.
Cool.
Powered by id Tech, this next-gen upgrade will
be free for everyone who owns
Doom Eternal. And on Series X, it will offer improved visuals at 60 FPS with ray tracing, a 4K mode, and an optional performance mode up to 120 FPS. Or maybe you're in the mood for an RPG like Skyrim, which marks its 10th anniversary this November.
It's 10th anniversary and it's 20th version.
So share your favorite Skyrim memories, stories, artwork, and more on Skyrim10.com. Or explore post-apocalyptic wasteland in Fallout 76. Everything you love about Fallout
they have
games.
Galt.
Custom camp building,
I've heard
storylines, warring factions, unique characters, places to discover.
All the Bethesda games now Xbox exclusive.
In fact,
not
Fallout
the existing
76
ones.
Is now one of the most popular games on Game Pass.
It seems like the ones going forward will be, because like they just announced Starfield, which will be Xbox exclusive. But obviously that also means PC, so Xbox and PC. Just like every other Xbox first party title.
Brotherhood of Steel are the guardians of human civilization.
New Vegas 2, you cowards! Well, that would be the other studio. I'm trying to remember what it was.
Fort Atlas is
what it was
safe.
Named. They did Outer.
It came at a great
the Outer Rim, I think it was called.
The Brotherhood must stand united. The super mutant threat takes priority. This proves more than anything.
Somebody, I'm sure, know in chat certainly knows. It just works. Amen.
You're splitting
it
our forces, Shin.
It just works.
The most important thing is finding everyone that has gone missing and returning them
home. It just works. Obsidian Entertainment, there you go. Thank you. I knew there was a B in there, but it didn't start. Outer World. Okay, so yeah, Obsidian and Outer World is the game. Thank you. Oh, they're also owned by Microsoft. Okay, then. Okay. I guess that makes sense, but awesome.
I set this plan in motion, and I am the only one who can stop it.
Choose justice.
The Brotherhood of Steel must protect the future of Appalachia and of the world. Your righteous crusade has gone too far.
While it may seem that we are fractured, I believe that we are now stronger than ever. This is a choice that can never be undone.
Well, from what I hear from my friends who are big fans of the Fallout series, this sounds like something they'd be interested in. So I always hear a lot about the Brotherhood of Steel.
What the hell was that?
Yeah, what do we have here?
Expedition Squad Delta, report. Over. Squad Delta, what's going on out there? Come on. This isn't funny.
I know you can hear
cool, whatever.
The Wasteland isn't the only open-world playground with an amazing community. The Elder Scrolls Codex Online Astartes from Cinemax Online Studio has now surpassed 18 million players and shows no signs of slowing down. Right now, our players are enjoying the new Blackwood chapter, part of the Gates of Oblivion year-long adventure. We've got a lot more to come in ESO, including the conclusion to this epic story later this fall with ESO Deadlands. And with the release of ESO Console Enhanced this Tuesday, the game will deliver a true native experience optimized for the Series X and S.
And I don't mean to be necessarily dismissive of the effort that's being put into these games when I say, okay, whatever. Even if it sounds that way. It's just not of interest to me, but you know, I can still respect the amount of work and talent that goes into these titles. Hey, look, a Stargate. Ooh, this is some good new. Like, even if I'm not big into Elder Scrolls, the music, man, the music. I highly doubt Bethesda will make a new Fallout or Elder Scrolls that's single player. They plan to make both ESO and 76 10-year games. Even so, I'm pretty sure there have been rumors of Elder Scrolls 6, haven't there? And I thought they confirmed that it was being worked on. Okay, another launch exclusive.
It's a new world with new rules.
Oh, hey, it's the nothing is off what is the his table. Name? John.
Winning this battle.
Crap, the epic trailer guy. Epic trailer for this guy. John something, wait. I think. I'm glad to see he gets. I like seeing when he gets worked though. Yeah, so Elder Scrolls 6 is in the work. I'm so confused. I don't know how to feel about this. This is so weird. And yet I'm intrigued. I love the way they move. It's hilarious. It looks like fun. What is this? I'm so confused. Damn. Okay, what's next? Oh, I need to play this. This looks so cool. I love the way the game. I've heard like nothing but good things about the game. I need to play this. Like, look at that. That's beautiful. Oh my god. And I don't know if this is the case in the game. The one thing I would love to see in any
stupid
piece of media.
Boy, I told you nobody gets out of here.
Try and stop me.
I would love to see any piece of media involving Greek mythology where Hades isn't the bad guy, where he's... Because Hades wasn't the devil. He wasn't evil. He was a very fair god. He was actually probably one of the best gods in the pantheon, all things considered. Like, the worst thing he ever potentially did, depending on your interpretation, was kidnap Persephone. And even that's, again, up for interpretation, depending on the exact mythology. Anyway. All right. Jump ship. Okay. I don't know if I've heard of them or not. It sounds vaguely familiar. Yeah, I've heard Hades is pretty okay in whatever that was in that last game was. Okay, this looks familiar. Thank you. Yeah, the new Halo game I would love to see. Oh, this looks like that game where you're that kid and you have to avoid, like, the shadows or whatever. Or not, if not that one. And there goes my Steam notifications, damn it. Oh well. This looks interesting, though. A nice small indie game. Damn it, Vellum, stop playing Mass Effect! Limbo, that was it. Yes, it looks a lot like Limbo. And it kind of looks like Inside, too. Yeah, it looks like both of those. I don't know who developed them, though, so... Somerville. Makes me happy to see indie games as big as they have been the last several years.
This holiday marks the
20th anniversary
of Xbox.
Oh, yes, here we go.
And the 20th anniversary of Halo.
Oh, they got Bonnie and Joe.
To our millions of passionate fans, thank you.
That beautiful Halo.
We wouldn't be here without all of you.
Halo time.
Our goal has always been to bring players together. And for the first time, we're thrilled to offer our entire multiplayer experience to all players across Xbox and PC with no barriers. Halo Infinite Multiplayer will be free to play and invite more of you than ever before to become a Spartan hero. I'm excited to be here with Joseph Staten, the creative director of Halo Infinite. From helping craft the original Halo Combat Evolved to leading the fan favorite Halo 3 ODST.
Yeah, ODST,
Joseph
baby!
Joseph is a Halo visionary. It is so great to have him back with Halo.
Thank you, Bonnie. And hey, everybody. For us, and I hope many of you, Halo has always been about heroism and wonder, about fighting to keep humanity safe against impossible odds in a beautiful and mysterious sci-fi world.
Oh!
This is just one part of the Zeta Halo ring, the largest, most wide-open environment we've ever built, and we can't wait for you to explore it.
Okay. Oh,
the heart
man.
Of Halo is Spartan 117, the Master Chief. In the next chapter of the Chief's story, you'll face his greatest challenge yet. But you're not alone in the fight.
Oh, the main batteries are shut down.
Oh, that's
stuck out here.
Oh. So this is right after he wakes up, I'm guessing.
Army. What can you do on your own?
I told you.
Oh, it's wow. Enough. They're really evoking that Halo 4, Halo 4 with this trailer. I love it. Love that reply, too.
I need you to understand. There's not much time.
Oh my god, look at that armor!
If you knew how you were going to die, you knew how you were going to die. How would you live your life differently?
Yeah.
What happened?
Clench.
Where is Cortana?
Whoa.
The rogue AI known as Cortana is gone.
Oh!
Been deleted.
What?
How? By you?
Of course not. Did you hit your head or something? Don't you remember? My instructions were to enter this installation, imitate Cortana, and lock her down for retrieval. Yours were to take her back to the Infinity for deletion. So if it wasn't you... Okay, then.
So they're just...
There's something they're just... else. On successful deployment, my deletion routine was supposed to complete. Still here.
Good. Something stopped your deletion. We need to find out why.
But
so Cortana's just going off screen.
The mission.
The mission's changed. They always do.
Are you sure?
I'll admit I like this new Cortana look, but I'm a little upset. I'm just a little upset.
Of course, you can't have a Halo game without multiplayer. Mm. And on Xbox Series X,
I hope she's not
able to enjoy Infinite's multiplayer action at up to 120 frames per second.
Okay, let's look
finally,
at multiplayer. Maybe
I'm very happy to announce that Halo Infinite's first free-to-play multiplayer season and Infinite's story-driven campaign will launch together this holiday.
Oh,
a new
okay.
day is upon us. A new generation built to fight. Together, we are unstoppable.
That was Soldier. Okay. Oh my god, this looks... Oh, nice. Okay. Oh! Grapple shot.
No,
nice. And... Interesting, there was no assassination. Ooh! That's interesting. Gonna have to wind up the. Oh, did you see that? He deflected the plasma bolt. And notice,
Hello.
I don't think this is FF.
Let's do some damage.
Interesting.
Skewer acquired.
Nice. Woo! Yes! Skyjack!
Claim the enemy flag. Return it to base. Ordnance drop inbound.
Oh, Pelican's actually bringing stuff in. That's awesome. Oh, that's so cool. I love this Banshee.
The flag is ours.
Okay, so yeah, they're dropping team colors
at your earliest convenience.
I love it. Was that a taunt earlier too? Yep, that's cool.
Now, show me what.
Oh, is that the new Shinobi armor? There you go, combat evolved. Oh my god, that's gorgeous. So still no release date, interesting. I just thought I would have thought by now they'd have a release, even a release month or something. I don't know. Damn, multiplayer looks really good. Yeah, Master Shredder.
Evil has survived. A dark figure wanders in the east. He must be stopped. At all costs.
Halo looks really damn good, too. Damn. Oh. So let's see. There's probably some articles going to go up, so let's go through these afterwards. That was a pretty good reveal overall, I have to say.
Hear me.
The new Halo AI looked awesome. Yeah. I like the look. It's like it's very clearly evocative of Cortana, and she sounds like young and naive in a way. Like you'd expect a newborn AI to be. Which, actually, really cool, too. I got some real offensive, or sorry, yeah, offensive bias vibes from her. So. Oh, shit. Diablo 2 Resurrected. I could swear there were some issues from the original fans about that. Or maybe I'm thinking of the Warcraft one. Yeah, I think I was thinking of Warcraft.
These things, where do they come from?
Where did they come from?
From
where
all
did
of us?
Where did they come from?
Cotton from what Joe. We do to him.
I am not it? Sorry.
I don't know. But he's my brother. And I would die for him.
Yeah, I really hope that Cortana isn't actually dead. So I'm gonna try and be a lot more, a lot less possibly negative when I break down that trailer. But anyway, yeah, it does kind of look like Baldur's Gate. I hope we get TV show news at the end of this though, because I don't want to just talk about leaked images if I ever talk about that. Game looks like a cartoon. What are you talking about? I'm a comedian now, okay. A Plague Tale, Requiem. Okay, there you go. Cortana was the lead. Yeah, it's, she says, but it could be a, they could be a, it could be a, what do you call that? A red herring. So.
It rings every hour, señor presidente.
Oh, okay. The new...
Hola, fascista.
Far... No. Far-
I recognize that voice.
I don't know.
Let me ask you a question. When I am dead and Yara is burning, what exactly is your plan?
Was that all... Hands, was that all 343 was going to show us?
Songs about, I mean, the fire?
I think that was kind of... It was kind of assumed that it wouldn't be a whole lot. It's 90 minutes and they're showing both Bethesda, which used to have its own hour-long...
Time you learn about resolver, Danny.
Like, show... And then take down Xbox, Castillo, which always did 90 minutes. The right so tool for the I don't know. I kind of went in assuming that we wouldn't see a whole lot. But we saw more than I thought. So
it's a stealth operation. I got you covered.
Maybe Cortana got taken by Harbinger.
Taking out a high-value target? I have just what you need.
Here we go. Okay.
You want to blow shit up? Juan Cortez at your service.
We have a lot of good stuff to show on, to look at. Some new articles were released on both Xbox Wire and the Halo Waypoint site.
Yara saw that shit. What? Wait a second. Who brought the rooster? Hey, whatever you need to get the job done, Danny.
Next time I see you, I want to play with that crazy backpack here.
Like how you resolver, Juan.
Oh, that's how you do it. Okay.
So do I.
I can't wait to talk. This week is going to be packed with Halo news, guys. I'm looking on Waypoint right now. Oh, I'm so excited. We'll talk about that after this is all done. Let's see. This started at noon. Wow, we're only 50 minutes into this? Holy crap.
Welcome back to Shreddageddon. Here's a new trick. Let's go.
Let the Cortana theories begin. Yeah, right now I'm thinking that Cortana was like taken by Harbinger or something. Whatever Harbinger ends up being. If it ends up being the Didact, that would be awesome. What if that's Cortana herself pretending to be the new AI? Maybe that's a big twist. That could be the case. I want to know what that new AI is named. Cortana. Jesus, that is weird to pronounce.
Okay, this is good. This is good. This is really good. Holy fluttering whip!
I used to play snowboarding games like nothing else when I was a kid on PS2. Maybe the real Cortana was the friends we made along the way. Oh, hello, Lego. What in the heck? What? I'm so confused. One sec, guys. Okay, back. This is so weird. They did these like pseudo-realistic graphics, and at the same time, it's very cartoony. Problem is, they have to explain how the Didact survived, and that's hard to explain. It really isn't. He got composed, and now he's in the dome, and then he's a digital lessons. It's a couple sentences if they really want to do, really want to dive into that. Where's Brohammer? He wasn't directly featured, but you heard him talking to the chief early in the campaign trailer. I wonder what's happening with the creative. Their leader is gone. Yeah, if their leader is gone. Oh, hold on. Sorry, I'm liking what I'm seeing here. Why is my phone vibrating? Shut up, phone. Oh, this looks gorgeous. Oh my god, yes. Someone was piggybacking on somebody else and had like walking sticks. Okay. Oh yes. Yes. All right. I'm sold. Visuals are beautiful. The action is beautiful, and I love this music. Okay, I'm getting this game. Holy crap, this looks amazing. You think the UNSC has lost its trust in smart AI? They actually have. That's pretty, I'd say it's almost expressly clear in Shadows of Reach. Like, they basically only use dumb AI, and even that's pretty limited.
in the first year of Grounded. Millions of players kept busy.
Looks stop motion-ish. It's like 12 frames per second sprite animations.
Fighting.
Cortana sounds like a dumb AI also. Yeah. That's why I'm thinking, like, I'm getting some offensive bias vibes, where, like, it's very clear from Shadows of Reach that she was created in the same manner as Smart AI, but she has a bunch of restrictions on her and what she can or cannot do. And obviously she had that, like, auto-delete protocol, so it's like, you're going to get to be around, and then we're going to kill you right away.
A lot of people want to sit. Pads for when you get sick of your human companions. And, of course, mushrooms. But not those kinds. We've also got something that literally no one was asking for. The Brood Mother. She's so terrifying. You should probably turn on arachnophobia mode. Ugh, even her blob scares the sh** out of us. Go big. Or never go home. Oh, and it looks like we added achievements too. Nice.
I've been meaning to play this. Oh, nice. 15 players. That's cool. Thoughts on the fate of Roland? I was surprised he wasn't mentioned in Shadows of Breach. So, I don't know. Like, I can't imagine them just ditching him entirely. Thoughts on the new armor coatings? I don't like the armor coating system at all. You're charging for colors, and I don't like that. When do Halo come out? It's already premiered. You can find the trailers on YouTube though. Charging. Okay, so I shouldn't have been so blasé about that. So I might have misused that word. So coatings are replacing the color system, as far as we can tell. And yeah, I mean, they're maybe not charging for colors. We actually don't know that for sure, but there's no way. I doubt those armor coatings aren't going to be charged in some manner. Like, some will absolutely be real money world purchases. Real-world money purchases, so... They aren't strictly charging for colors, but the only way to customize your Spartan is with armor coatings, and you're gonna have to buy those. That might be in-game, some of that might be real-world money, but... Also, seems like we can change the announcer's voice for what they call smart... Those would be dumb AIs based on the vocal patterns. They're more akin to dumb AIs.
You have shown an aptitude for applying lethal solutions to conflicted situations. We wish to test your abilities.
How much will campaign cost? I don't think they've said. But we basically have a week of E3 ahead of us, so maybe during that we'll get some extra details. I wonder what's happening with Guardians, with their leader gone. Are they back asleep, or are they still against us? We'll have to find out. Basically, guys, if you're questioning it, there's most likely not an answer out there. Not to say stop asking questions at all. Don't stop. But that's more likely something like there's maybe a lot of things to
those who made for us to experience in game,
which is good. You don't want to know the story going into it. You want to have an idea of what to experience, but you don't want to know.
Into kingdoms.
I need Gears of War content. You and me both.
Into legends.
scene.
If somebody brought up the Dyadic Dead already, if they dealt with Pax Cortana off screen,
what would you
it will be Extinction Dyadic 2.0. Yeah, that will be extremely disappointing if they actually did kill her off screen. Infinite will have training bots. Oh shit, really? I haven't read it every.
Where would you go? What will you be remembered for?
Yeah, AI controlled bots for training bed. Nice. And there is an Avery J. Johnson Academy of Military Science in the universe now.
We begin by hearing an old, wise-sounding voice. Mm-hmm. And we see a quiet, peaceful setting.
This yeah, I can only imagine what our Halo is up to right now.
Now, something must break the serenity. Will this creature be in the game? No. Say goodbye to it forever.
What?
Suddenly, and for no reason... People
thoughts
running.
On the new multiplayer for Infinite? I'm loving what I'm seeing.
These pointless slow motion shots.
It looks like a nice
make
mix.
Everything seem cool and should bolster pre-sale numbers.
Okay, this trailer's getting really meta. Sorry, hold on. I'm getting distracted.
Sound can mean only one thing. We must gaze over an epic shot of a world, and there should be lens flares. Now we see our hero. But only their silhouette, because the developers haven't finished the design. Or finished the story. Or finished any gameplay that's actually ready to show. In fact, the only thing they have finished is the title.
Oh. Oh my god! Okay, now I really have to play Outer Worlds. Oh man. Yeah, I've seen the new post. As soon as the Xbox thing is done with, I'm planning to pull that up on screen, just kind of read through it. And then of course, you know, later today I'll start pumping out videos. It's gonna be an all-nighter. I had to whip out the hazmat suit before I journeyed to our Halo, yeah. Microsoft Flight Simulator. Overall, it seems like everyone's really satisfied with the way Halo looks, so that's pretty good. Travel the game, yeah. Still haven't uploaded the campaign footage. I wonder if there's more to come. Didn't they? I thought they did. Oh, are we getting, what's it called? Top Gun, the Top Gun? Site, though it seems to be live elsewhere. Cortana, in my opinion, I prefer it over the old. I like it. I prefer the old one. I like the way she looks. Yeah, like it's evocative of Cortana, but it's very clearly not Cortana. So, and that's what I would expect. It sucks, but I'm kind of just wanting this to end now. Did not mean to touch that.
Ooh, let everybody talk right now. Tell me what you want right now. You could get it.
Yeah, well, you can get it. Yeah, yeah, you can get it.
She seems younger, like I said. Yeah, like she's very much new. So it's like it's not just her looks. Her attitude is very much distinguishes her from Cortana. And obviously she sounds different. Fingers still crossed for something Gears of War related. I think they said they aren't working on anything new for like a few years. Get it.
Hello, I'm Mike Brown, creative director at Playground Games, and I can't wait to show you what we've been working on. Horizon is known for fun, freedom, and beauty. This year, the Horizon Festival arrives in beautiful, diverse Mexico. This is the largest and most diverse open world ever in a Forza Horizon game. And there is no better car to explore it than the stunning AMG Project One Forza Edition. Rendered in unparalleled detail and with ray tracing in Forza Vista, thanks to the power of the Xbox Series consoles. I've invited along some of the team to help give you a taste of some of the amazing content that's waiting for you in Forza Horizon 5. Please welcome Bill, Maddie, Sierra, and Don from the Forza team.
Hey, Mike.
Hey, guys, what's up?
Hey, everyone.
Hey, what's up, Mike?
And we also have Abraham with us as well. He's one of the talented actors who will be appearing in the game.
Bienvenidos a Mexico. I can't wait to show you what we've been working on.
We begin in the rainforest on an expedition. This is a new campaign mode in which you set out on an adventurous journey across Mexico to explore new locations and discover places for the festival to expand.
It's always interesting how much attention.
There you are. How's the expedition going?
I'm racing a car through the Mexican jungle, Rami. Doesn't get much better than this.
We'll minimize that for a sec. Let's spring over.
I can see some ruins up ahead.
Where are you? Okay. Let's start with the Xbox wire.
This city is still a jewel of Mayan architecture.
Just for a moment. So, Halo Infinite, The Great Journey So Far by Joe Staten. And they have a deeper dive over on Halo Waypoint. We're definitely going to look at that before this stream ends, so don't worry. Hold up. Yeah, like we were talking about, they got rid of team colors, so that'll be, I'm guessing, maybe they're going to do something like, I remember Gears 3 did, like, outlines for players at a distance, so maybe they'll be doing something like that. Major focus. Even though launch is a huge moment, it's just the beginning of Halo Infinite's great journey. Always appreciate a good pun. major focus for our teams, content. Tons of Spartan customization options that will be part of our first season. Heroes of Reach, including a super sweet Yori Spartan. So that was probably the samurai-esque one that we saw. So this pretty much confirms a battle pass. The Ori armor is free, and you can unlock it just by playing events in Season 1. Okay, cool. Playing events. I wonder what that's going to entail. Multiplayer experience. It honors classic Halo combat. Players need to jump in and have a great time. Introducing the Spartan Academy and Spartan Commander Loretta, who will help players familiarize themselves with maps, weapons, and yada, yada, yada. Okay. I'll be interested to learn more about her. I'm guessing she was the person we heard in the trailer. More in store for bots and Academy content, as we were talking about. New Cortana looks like the old one, but different at the same time. Yep. This map looks gorgeous. Look at that Halo ring. We'll get to see. Yeah, let's do this. Look at that. That is beautiful. Yeah, you can see a little moon back there. That's cool. I wonder if this is actually meant to be Installation 04. Or if this is Installation 08 at the old 04 site. That kind of looks like Basis, but we don't know enough about the Installation 07 system to say if it is or isn't. Halo Infinite is a game that will grow over time with a community. Important. Dedicated to listening to your feedback, continuing to improve a game over time. That's good. Try new things. That's good to hear. Listen closely to the community. We'll get a chance to really dig in, deliver new experiences for our players, like maps and modes. We also have a few surprises up our sleeve, which you'll see in the months following our launch this year. So probably subtle way of referring to campaign DLC.
Captured 24 hours.
Okay, so that's still going. Why does Forza always get so much attention? That's kind of annoying. We talked about fans and Fight Infinite blog. Yeah, we know about that. Let's check out the new Ghost quickly. Very Banished. I can't wait. This looks so much fun. The Banshee looks great. I'm thinking that might be a skewer shot there. Looks like any other Halo to me. What's cringe about? Somebody said it's cringe? I wonder if she's replacing Palmer. No, she's probably not replacing Palmer. I think Jennifer Hale said she was in. She confirmed that she's in Infinite. So I think she did. Don't quote me on that. Maybe she's related to Johnson. No, I doubt that. And I mean, if she is, that'd be cool, but let's not have another lock situation. I also want to check out yada, yada, yada. Lastly, today, while we celebrate Halo Infinite's multiplayer experience, I'd be remiss if I didn't speak on the tantalizing bits of campaign we shared. Story of the Master Chief from Halo 5, but also telling a story that's welcoming to new players. Cortana Fate is one of the campaign's big mysteries, and early in the story, you meet a new UNSC AI, the Weapon, as they're calling it for now. I'm guessing that we'll either hear the name in-game, they don't want to tell that, or it's going to just be called the Weapon, and she'll, like, get a name as time goes on. Is this still Forza? So weird. Game be wack, yo. Together with the pilot, the Master Chief, and the Weapon. Yeah, so I'm guessing they're purposely keeping the new UNSC AI's name a secret. I'd love if it were a Durandal or a Durandal, depending on how you want to pronounce that.
Oh, okay. Team Xbox is on mission to bring the joy and community of gaming to everyone on the planet. That's why you, the gamer, are at the center of everything we do. Today, we showed you 30 games. 27 of them will be available on Xbox Game Pass. Now, through the end of the year, you can look forward.
We're kind of hoping it's in November.
Monthly releases
release for Infinite.
Day one on Game Pass, led by 5 new titles from Xbox Game Studios, as well as highly anticipated games like Back for Blood, 12 Minutes, and The Ascent. And as we look ahead to next year, I'm inspired by the creativity of Bethesda and Xbox Game Studios. We showed
they will get a classic weapon DLC, probably.
RPG Starfield, coming exclusively to Xbox. But we also have some of the industry's best RPG storytellers working on Avowed, Fable, The Elder Scrolls Online, Fallout 76, The Outer Worlds 2, and Elder
By the way,
Scrolls
do you have
6.
The Mega Constructs?
We unveiled the
prototype exosuit. Yes, I got all three of those exosuits.
Shooter in Halo Infinite. Adding to the roster of iconic Xbox shooters alongside Wolfenstein, Gears of War, Perfect Dark, and Doom. We premiered the most epic open world racing game, Forza Horizon 5.
Do we need gold for multiplayer? Hopefully not.
Mexico,
it's free to play, and that would kind of go against the notion of free to play if you needed gold for it.
While the team at Turn 10 is hard at work,
but
on
I don't think they've said
Forza Motorsport.
If they have said, it might be in those
Our
articles I haven't read that I haven't read yet.
23 Studios is devoted
well,
to advancing the medium we all love. Xbox has been here for 20 years, and that's because of you. Our team strives to make Xbox a place where you'll find the greatest games, the most dedicated developers, and the most passionate community. Together, we all make Xbox the best place to play. Before I go, there's one more thing. Take a look at this brand new original game from the Arkane team at Bethesda, the studio that created Prey and Dishonored. Arkane created something new.
Think Halo 5 versions of weapons could still appear? Anything's possible at this point, guys.
That you can
Anything.
Play alone or with your friends. And like Starfield, this game
we'll come back to her
Xbox
in a moment.
Exclusive.
Does Xbox Gold even exist anymore? Technically, yes, to my knowledge. Okay, so what's this? Okay, modern world with magic. I can dig that. Apocalypse world with magic and technology.
Centimeters, dramatically elongated. Go on, make yourself useful.
Hey, look, it's the crow.
So, that was fun, right?
I'm genuinely curious what this is. I like the setting.
That's your cue, mate.
Sleep tight.
The
Himalayas. You think they can't kill you anytime they want?
Hey, asshole!
And now for the dark twist. Okay, so vampires. Getting some 30 Days of Night vibes from that design. But, how they get it. I like
the field in Redfall, Massachusetts. Behind me, we are witnessing clear signs of cult activity as the locals engage.
Hey!
Always the Brits' fault.
Really hope the video was worth it.
Everybody, fall back! People need to know what happened.
Wonder if Halo multiplayer will allow up to 100 players on the same map. That'd be cool. Huh, nice.
Where's the other one?
Freeze him and stake him. This seems like a fun game. Did you see the leaks of the Halo show? Yep. BTB is confirmed to be 24 players. Nice.
Oh shit. Dev's gonna love this one.
Oh, hey, it's death. I don't know.
You better have a plan, Jacob.
Yep. Don't miss.
Don't touch me.
Rip no playable leads again. Yeah, but we knew that for a while now. Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah, I think there's vampire in this.
Really? What does it taste like? Be specific.
Like blood and death and strawberry.
The sun's coming up. Let's keep moving.
Let's keep moving.
Sure thing, Edgar Allan Bro.
That's a good one.
Do you think things will ever go back to normal?
Would you want to go back to normal?
Not if I still have to pay my student loans.
Oh my god, that's relatable. Oh my god, he's turning the sun into a black hole. Cool. Redfall. Looks interesting. Wonder about the hole created in Guardians. That is the big question. The big question. Ooh. Ooh, that my shoulder is killing me there. Yeah, those vampires look very much inspired by 30 Days of Night.
If there is wonder, that place in our dream.
Oh, okay, so this is the wrap-up. It's kind of sad to see no Fable. So I know some other people were looking for that. Oh. What about beta for multiplayer flights on Halo? We know it's coming, and we know it's been tested with a small group of people outside the studio. There's a theory that Reach armor and the new/redesigned armor will be separate in customization, no mix and matching. So far, nothing directly disproving it. I wouldn't look for things to disprove. As you're making a positive claim. You don't. The positive claim has to be supported. It's not. You're not supposed to rip down a positive claim. Or the positive claim has the burden of proof. What's the point of a beta this close to launch? There's always value in player feedback. They can rebalance things. They can tweak minor things. Especially they can test out network connection and make sure their netcode is working. Maybe Harbinger is behind everything. That's my guess. Okay, so that's it. So no Halo TV show. Look at that going down. Shooting down. Okay, so let's go back to this quickly. All right. I think we were actually at the end. Yada, yada, yada. Okay. I am about to sneeze again. Okay, here's the big one. Halo Infinite Multiplayer. So... This was posted as the trailer went live, and you can see here there's a whole bunch they're going to be talking about just this week. 343 Industries, Halo Infinite Multiplayer Overview, more gameplay and insights from the team, debut at 8 a.m. PT tomorrow. I'll definitely be live streaming that. Halo Infinite Mark 7 Spartan Cosplay Guide. That is freaking awesome. I'm like, once they did the rookie guide, I was hoping for more, and I'm so glad they're doing that for this. Especially because if it's anything like the rookie guide, it's going to have a bunch of lore in there. Everything you need to know to create your own real-life Spartan here on Waypoint. Cannon fodder, baby! Wednesday, 6/16, Grim Brother 1 dives into the fiction behind the multiplayer maps, vehicles, armor, and more. Hell yes. And then a new Inside Infinite. Okay, so that'll be next week, I think, or the week after. I think that might be the week after, because, yeah, this Thursday is 14, 15, 16, 17. No, it'll be next week. Okay. At least it's broken up just a bit, because this week is going to be packed as fuck. So let's see. Quintessential Halo. Yada, yada, yada. Toys. Halo Infinite Sandbox punctuates the addition by Halo of 3 Halo 3S equipment. Yada. Today's trailer, you'll catch a glimpse of two additional pieces of equipment. The threat sensor is an area of effect support device that periodically pulses. So basically, Promethean Vision. But as we kind of saw in the trailer, you have to launch it yourself. So it's an equipment this time. And it has a radius. Okay. And the repulsor. That's what blasted back the plasma pistol launch. That was awesome. That is really damn cool. Equipment. Yep. Okay. Yeah, 4K. My guys obviously won't be able to fully appreciate it on the stream, but here we go. Ugh. Just looks gorgeous. Yeah, I really can't. I think actually, okay, so that's a Needler round. New generation, built to fight. I'm sure all Spartans meet UNSC's high bar and have skills necessary. We are excited to introduce the all-new Academy. Under the mentorship of Spartan Commander Loretta, the Spartan Academy offers players the opportunity to hone their skills and get better acclimated with the armaments and environments of Halo Infinite. That's really good to hear. Recruits will be able to dial in their marksmanship in a target range or jump right into customizable training skirmishes and square off against AI. That's really cool. Question is, will we be able to add AI to Forge maps, and will you be able to have AI matches? Like, can you bring people in on both teams and fill in empty space with bots? Can you have big team battle with bots? Lets you configure a specific moat, loadouts, deploy opponent bots of various skill levels. That's good. Practice on your own terms. Bot can be configured in custom games to tailor the experience and even fill... Oh, there you go. Fill in roster spots for MIA fire team members. That's what happens if you don't stop and read the entire thing. You can see here, solid orange Spartan with some grime. A little bit cleaner here, but you got the camo pattern. Nice. Bots to spar. Skill-based matchmaking and improved systems that deliver better communication to players. I'm guessing that's what those AI are. Okay, maps, modes, and more. Halo's arena continues to be defined by fair starts and teams working closely to control key areas of the map. Scavenging is also a key component. Remember your academy training, jump in. And revel in accolades of legendary multiplayer announcer Jeff Steitzer. So that's awesome. A little preview of that map that we got to see earlier. What is it here? It's called Multiplayer Map 06 right now. Glad there's a Spartan school now. Yep. Halo Marines were bots in Warzone. Yeah, but we didn't have, like, you couldn't fill them in with in custom games. And I'm still salty over the fact that Warzone didn't have an offline mode, that it was pure online. Anyway. Releases this holiday, will usher in a long way to return of BTB. Classic series Stalwart is back, bigger and better than ever, supporting 24 players, as we heard, on large, vehicle-friendly maps, tapping into the full extent of the sandbox. It's the epitome of the Halo experience and the ultimate Spartan battle fantasy, with Pelicans swooping in to deploy fresh vehicles, weapon ordnance dropping from the sky, and tactical updates from Commander Loretta. That's awesome. BTB is the wild, raw shit. Raxious, I don't know. Fun social experience that cranks everything up to 11. There'll be more details over the summer. Ranked in social playlists. So that's good to hear. They're both coming back. Players will be able to experience limited time seasonal events, So there's that, with special rewards on the line. Console and PC, Console and PC players will get to play together via crossplay, while support for cross progression means you can freely move freely from one platform to the other and keep your Spartan journey. That's awesome. We already knew that, but still cool to hear. Xbox Series X 120 FPS, wide variety of stuff on PC. Halo Infinite will also support split screen on Xbox and LAN via PC local server. Okay. Oh, man. Look at this. Hold on. If I could open the damn thing. Look at these Spartans. Yep. Look at all that custom gear. The only thing I'm a little disappointed about right now is it's very clear they're going the Reach route, where it's a base armor with stuff on top. One thing I liked about Halo 4 is that it wasn't just stuff being added on top. It was different armor sets. And I hope we get a mix of that at the very least. Anyway, check this out. Robotic arm, baby. That's cool. Oh, man. These helmets look pretty good. That, I'm guessing it... Jesus, look at that visor. Is it going to be visor? Well, we know there's going to be some visor customization, but Jesus, look at that. This is kind of cool, too. So, stuff adding onto the helmet so you can change the way the visor looks. Kind of get a more 343-esque helmet look if you want. Here's the Anubis helmet. This looks like the soldier helmet. I should turn on my damn mouse so you guys can actually see. Hold on. Display. Okay, sorry. I just realized I had my mouse off. Oop. Okay, so mouse in. Oh, it gets bigger. Okay, so yeah. Anubis, I think, is over here. We have the soldier over here in its appropriate green. And I'm trying to remember what this was called in Halo 4 and 5. But I'm drawing a blank right now. This kind of looks EVA-esque, but I don't know that it's EVA. We'll have to see. Okay. This just looks gorgeous, though. Armor Hall offers more per-piece customization options than any other prior Halo game, including everything from helmets to visors to gloves to shoulder pads and more. Good to hear. Doesn't stop at armor, though. You'll be able to earn and apply coatings to weapons and vehicles, which we already knew. That helpful, humorous voice you hear in the trailer, it's one of an example of new personal AI. I'm guessing that's this right here. That you'll be able to equip during multiplayer matches. They also help capture objectives, as pictured below. Okay. Final game will include even more ways to customize your Spartan that we're showing today. So yeah, more to come. It's very superintendent-esque, these personal AI, so that's cool to see. Halo Infinite team has designed a new friend or foe system for multiplayer at a high level. This function is an outline system that uses different colors to denote friends and foes. So yeah, there we go. Colors are configurable for accessibility purposes. Nice. I think I've said this online, but I would love like an entire Inside Infinite dedicated to accessibility options for Halo Infinite. Halo insiders will be able to check it out firsthand during technical previews later this summer. So there we go. Probably not this month, so maybe July or August. Back when we first announced, we talked about the importance of community would play in development and beyond via flighting. We've seen firsthand the good that comes and powers. While our schedule shifted due to the pandemic and development timelines, our commitment was not lost. Later this summer, we plan for limited pre-release technical previews with insiders to help us stress test and improve the game on the road to launch. More details in the later. Make sure your your Halo Insider profile is up to date. Let's get a look at this pelican up close. I really want to know if this is like a D78, a D77, what the model is. I want to know what the model is. Regardless, though, it looks damn gorgeous. Okay. Well, that's pretty much it for now. Except I got to get off and do some video making very soon. Sorry, guys, I'm not sold on this yet. It looks kind of interesting, but bad. I don't know, like, if you're talking visually, I don't know how you can call this bad looking, but gameplay-wise, you know, that's entirely, you know, is going to have an opinion on that. But it's in a BTB match. So the Pelicans are, according to this article, the Pelicans will actually drop in ordnance and, or sorry, not ordnance, there are ordnance drops, but it'll drop in vehicles. So rather than vehicles spawning in, you'll have Pelicans dropping, bringing them in. It's actually in the trailer too. Oh, is that? Oh yeah, that is ODST armor. How did I miss that? Thank you for pointing that out, Halo Prov. Yeah, that's an maybe not armor because this is mostly Mark set, but yeah, that's an ODST helmet. Classic ODST too, very much so. Not Helljumper or Nightfall. Nice. Oh yeah, we should. There's the new sidekick. Look at that thing. Beautiful. Okay. Oh, man. Well, thank you all for joining me. I had fun talking with y'all, especially once Halo came up. I'm really excited for the multiplayer, if nothing else. Got to gather my thoughts on the campaign stuff. But for now, thank you all for watching. Stay tuned later today. I'm going to dive right into making breakdown videos on the multiplayer and campaign. And then, let's see. Next thing is, yeah, we're going to have even more info tomorrow, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Lots of stuff to talk about this week. It's going to be great. So, see you around, guys.